Hello, welcome back. Let's talk about sofrito. Sofrito is an ingredient that consists of several ingredients that are blended together using a food processor, and then it's preserved so you can use it for to create your base when you're cooking stews. You use the sofrito, you use tomato sauce, you use olive oil, and maybe a couple other ingredients, and you create that base. And in Puerto Rico, we use it for a lot of different types of meals. Now, a lot of people get intimidated around the world when they see a video about how to cook certain Puerto Rican food. And they say, well, we don't have sofrito, we cannot do it. But actually, you can. Because all you have to do is use most or all the vegetables that you already use to create your sofrito, and the sofrito that you preserve, and all you have to do is just cut them and use the right vegetables, cut the right size, and prepare your sofrito real time without having to use the blender. And that's it, you have the same flavor, exactly the same meal. And this is what I'm going to show you. So go nowhere, let's create. These are five ingredients. In essence, it's pretty much what we call sofrito. Now, I pre-prepared the sofrito so I can cook meals like this. However, if you don't have sofrito, you can substitute by doing this. You get a little bit of cilantro, a little bit of fresh oregano. See, this is a tiny bit. Look at the finger, my finger. A tiny bit of onions. Just a little bit. This is about a tablespoon and a half. About a tablespoon and a half of sweet green peppers. I have red and orange. You could have some green too, like the bell pepper, but you just need a little bit for this particular meal. And I have about 2 tooth of garlic, which I mince or a squish, you know? So you have a pot, you know, relatively small, and you have your heat high. And in this hot pot, what you do is just start with the 2 pieces of meat. But you have a little bit of your oil, not a lot, just a little bit. You add your onions. Because now you're creating your sofrito, your pepper, your oregano, and your cilantro. Back out a little bit. Let me lower the heat to medium for now. Add your garlic. Let it simmer for about a few seconds, you know. You don't want to burn. Oh my goodness, this smells good. You add the tomatoes. Now you're creating the true base. See how the base looks? Now what I do is add a little bit of the cumin. Just a little bit, not a lot, just a little bit. You can smell it now.